In India, we're all waiting for the monsoons. And they're so much worried because the rain did not come. So I was giving bandhan to the rain and it came here. And now also they have told on the television that it is going to rain in India. But first in Italy. I was told that in Italy you needed rain very much. And the first rain you had few days back, and now this is the second one. Because all the understanding of the problems of our farmers is there. And the rain, you see, is so kind that it works at the right time. I'm surprised at the quick behavior and obedience of the rain. Today is a great day for all of us because we are celebrating the Guru Puja and remembering all the great Gurus who came on this earth to teach the world about the truth. So many of them were here. And they tried their level best to explain to humanity what is spirituality. But it's such a disparity that people never understood that spirituality is the most important thing we need. That we have to be one with the divine power. All their endeavor have been in the wrong direction. First, of course, they were very intelligent, more than animals, and started seeking not the truth, but some sort of a self-emancipation, I should say, I don't know what to say for it. Self-progress. And in that they lost that they have to first seek spirituality, which is the most important thing. But we had two types of journeys. One is through the left side or another through the right side. In India, I don't know why, we had lots of people who went into the jungles and became saints, but they were doing right side tapasya. That is going into the five elements one after another and mastering the five elements. Of course, there is truth in it, no doubt. You have seen how a candle tells you as to what is your position inside. If you are possessed or if you are not. A candle can tell you, can you imagine? Candle is so much knowledgeable. Supposing you have a heart. heart trouble, the candle will show. And if you treat yourself with a candle, you can cure yourself. So it is so sensitive, not that it can cure, but also so competent. Not that it shows you that you are sick and you have problem, but it is competent to cure. That's why in India, Agni was worshipped. This light was worshipped. The fire was worshipped. That was worshipped. They must have discovered that the fire knows everything. So the inner awareness of all these elements, they knew about it, and that's why they worship those elements. So before the puja, they used to call all the deities who belonged to those elements to witness their puja. But that turned out to be right-sided movement. Without the left side, right side is very dangerous. If you don't have right side, of course, it's a big dangerous thing also. But first you must have development of your left side. That is what to begin with we had in Sahaja. Left side is compassion, is love, universal feeling. Or we can say is the blessings of the Devi, which are described, you know, as in the Devi Mahatma, that the Goddess resides within you as so many things. She resides in you as Shraddha, as she resides in you as sleep. She resides in you as illusion, Bhranti. All kinds of things are there on the left hand side, which are already described. And when I told you about Sahaja Yoga, I wanted to make your left side very strong. Those people who took to right side became very aggressive people, and they had mastered the essence of these five elements, that's all right. But they were extremely hot-tempered, so much so that they used to curse people, curse them. They used to say things which were not kind, and they didn't believe in the universality. It was such a dangerous thing that they took. In Indian Shastras, you can see many incidents where people gave a curse, shap, very common. All these gurus used to curse a person because they had no compassion, no love, nothing, but they had powers of the right side. We have seen now that those people who have right side, who go only on the right side without the bhakti, without the blessing of the Divine, can become rakshasas actually, can become a great danger for humanity. This is a very serious thing. Through your intelligence, through your thinking power, your ego can go to any limit and create problems within you. Now the ultimate of this problem is, we have seen, is are many diseases which are absolutely incurable. Even some people, right-sided some people, can get a kind of a cancer called blood cancer. And this blood cancer, now we have cured it. But even if it is cured, you can go back to that kind of aggressiveness, thinking that you are very right. Such people always try to find faults with others. That such and such person is not good, is being harm, or anyway, they can find faults with others, not with themselves. Their attention is outside, not on themselves. They never see what's wrong with them, but they always see what's wrong with others. By doing that, you see, they are climbing the ladder of a horrible right side which can give you horrible diseases. As I've told you, first is the blood cancer. If you get rid of the blood cancer, then you can get into another problems. Nowadays, there's a very famous disease called Alzheimer's. This is also the side of the right side. Because if you don't have that bhakti, that humility, that blessings of the goddess, you can develop all such horrible diseases which are not only fatal but also very injurious to others. So by being right-sided, you do not progress. You can become a big ascetic, they call it, who can curse others, who can put them into troubles, think that that is a great power. It is not. It is not at all. Because though you are not suppressed by other powers, negative powers, but your own power takes your life. So, Kundalini, when it is arisen, the best thing is to go to the left side. Not criticizing others, not talking ill of others, but seeing within you what's wrong. Find out what is the matter with you. First, it starts with self-importance. That I am a very important person. And with this self-importance you go on troubling everyone and torturing everyone and all that. But because of your right side movement, you can become very successful. Hitler was the climax of that. And that's how people start taking to very, very cruel things. Nowadays, I think that some people are ruling everywhere with their right side. We do not have people who are using their left side. And whenever they use their left side, they are called as saints. Now, you all have the powers of the left side. Some of you do have little bit right side also. Doesn't matter. Now I would say that you have achieved your left side mastery. Kundalini awakening is there, you are one with the Divine. Now, You can't come to the right side and know about right side. And try to express your right side. You can express it not by dominating others, but dominating yourself. By self-examination. By understanding what's wrong with you. Why do you behave like that? Why do you trouble others? Why do you overpower others? Such people will always, I've seen, organize and arrange and do this and do that. Instead of organizing themselves, they'll organize others. These things complicate. But if you have love and if you have bhakti, you can very, very easily dominate others in a very different manner. It is not that you dominate by cruelty, by oppression, but you dominate with your love. And you don't want to dominate. But easily people get very much succumbed to love and to magnanimity, to generosity. So all these qualities you must first develop within yourself. It's the left side problem, that you should be very peaceful. You should give love to others. You should be generous. You should be kind. And see how much it pays. I've seen some people who are extremely rude. They can be rude to anyone. That's their nature, which they should overcome with the left side. Rudeness is not the sign of a saint. The saint is extremely peaceful and never gets rude with others. So the introspection should work first of all. Where are we wrong? What wrong things we are doing? What is our style? Once you discover that your style is already left side, then you should take to right side and possess the power of right side. What are the powers of right side now, which are achieved through the left side perfection? We have some very great gurus on this line. One of them was Raja Janaka. He was a ruler of a country and a very well-known ruler and everything, but still, though he was so generous and good and everything, but at the same time, he was a great monarch, great king of those days. Very much known for his impartiality, for his statesmanship, and all kinds of beautiful things he did for his subject. That is there is Raja Janaka. He could not get disturbed with anything. And people never understood why the greatest of greatest saints used to bow to him. What was so great, though he was a king, he was living so lavishly, and he had so many of ornaments and also conveyances and all that. Because nothing was above him. He was so detached with everything. He had everything, but he was so detached. That's a very good example of a person who had mastered his left and now who was the king. Raja Janaka was the king. Like that, we had many people later on also, one after another, who were extremely, extremely rich, extremely, I should say, powerful as kings, but inside they were absolutely like divine personality. Nothing disturbed them, nothing made them feel greater or happier. No position, no power was to them great. This is a complete emancipation of human beings. That you are, realize so. You should be fully equipped with compassion, love and understanding. But at the same time, it should be expressed in the right way. For example, we can say Christ is another example. Though he was an incarnation, still the amount of forgiveness and love he has for people is tremendous. But at the same time, he used to go on the mountains and preach about spirituality. Those were not very safe times, because people didn't like anybody talking like that. They hated him because he talked about God. And what they did to him, you know very well. Doesn't matter. Though they crucified him, still we all respect him as a great personality. Reason is, he was no doubt an incarnation. But still he went all out to give his achievements, or I can say whatever powers he had to others. He went all over the places. He had no facilities, but still he went out to many people and tried to save them. This was the right side movement. That means sahyogis can also become right sided. But like Christ. Otherwise, if they are right sided, they'll organize, they'll do all kinds of things and have problems of the right side. That's why I want you to avoid the right side. But once you are fully left-sided, master of Sahaja, then it's very, very much needed to be a complete personality of spirituality that you should take to right side movement. And what is the right side movement is the collectivity. Should not be satisfied with what you have got. It's very easy to feel, oh, now we have got realization, now what is there? We are on top of the world. That's not so. You have to go out, talk to people. They will insult you, they'll trouble you, they'll do all kinds of things. But you are already a person, already a realized soul. You can listen to them, what they are saying. You will not ask for anything. What you'd like to do, good to them. This is also a compassion, that you don't want to keep your realization to yourself, but you want to do it for others also, so that they also get realization. It's very important. If you do not feel that way, the pity for people who haven't got realization, think of the times you were not realized. These people are also not realized and they are having a bad time. They can be in for any trouble. So now it's not that if you have got realization, you settle down with it. No, that's not the way. But you should go all out to see that you give realization to others and save them. You all have got realization, not for your sake. It's not limited for you, but it is meant for others, that you have to give it to others. And as soon as you will start giving it to others, you will be amazed so many qualities in you will come up. Because when you see others, you find that what is lacking in them, what do they need, what you have to give, how you have to give. You can become anything, you can become a poet, you can become a writer, you can, anything can be become in case you face others. Then it comes as a reaction within you, all these qualities develop. And you become a very good, I should say, artist. This is only possible if you meet other people and talk to them about Sahaja Yoga and tell them about your Self-Realization. I know there will be problems, no, that is true. There will be people who will oppose you, say all kinds of things against you, and they'll try to stop your activities and do all kinds of harm, doesn't matter. But that's the thing you should achieve, is to meet people, talk to them, and start telling them about Self-Realization, you have to save them. That's important. But first of all, you should know that you should have no right-sided complications. Otherwise, they'll all run away. A person who is spiritual is supposed or accepted to be a very humble person. Of course, because he is humble, people will take advantage of him, say all kinds of things. It's all right. It's a part of the game. But he doesn't mind. He doesn't mind anything. Anything that comes his way, he doesn't mind. But what is the main thing is that he has compassion. His compassion that he had before from the left side is now expanded. And he wants to save the people. People don't have food is all right, is a big complication. If people are starving is another. But if they do not get spirituality, what's the use of their human life? Why did they evolve to this state? They are evolved from animal state, from the worst possible conditions to a human state. And now if they do not get their realization, that means this is worse than starving, worse than all kinds of poverty, worse than all kinds of diseases and troubles. So why not try to give them realization? Why not see that you give them realization? But first and foremost thing, as I said, that in the left you should be very strong. You shouldn't start doing it because you have got your realization. You can give realization. So you should not start doing it unless and until you have strengthened your left side. Such a person is extremely humble, extremely straight, doesn't grudge about anything, doesn't grumble about anything, and can adjust itself into any circumstance. It is not attached to anything. It's an automatic detachment. It doesn't have to tell. You may do anything for that person, you may try to get anything for that person, it's all right. That person will accept, no doubt, but without any attachment to anything. Such a detached person is the one who can work it out. All kinds of propagation of Sahaja Yoga. Today that is the greatest need of the world, that we have to have more Sahaja Yogas. Now people are so shy to do that. It's very surprising. But I have seen people who don't have any truth, who have all kinds of bad gurus, get after others, try to spread their false ideas. But Sahaja Yoga is, why should they feel? Why should they feel shy? I don't understand. So talk about this to everyone. Bring them to Sahaja Yoga. It's a very important day because as a Guru Puja, they say that a guru cannot give anything to you. But I can give you the advice. And the advice that you enlarge your heart. You become humble and try to spread Sahaja Yoga with humility, not with aggressiveness. That is extremely important. If you can do that, then you will do full justice to this life, which is a spiritual life. Without that, you cannot achieve the strength of spirituality. For that, you have to understand that it's very, very important that you should give Sahaja Yoga a full chance through your wisdom. What I receive mostly, the letters are that this person is troublesome, that person is troublesome, that person is doing like that. Forget it. All such persons are not important for a Sahaja Yoga. But if you start on proper lines, you will be amazed. You will meet so many people who want peace of mind, peace of heart, and a complete oneness with the Divine. They may not accept, they may not say, they might have gone to the wrong people also, possibly. But despite everything, they would like to have a real spiritual peace within themselves. It's a very common desire nowadays among people. But to approach that and to reach that, you have to take to a life of a very simple personality. See, if you are so much interested in money, or if you are so much interested in your so-called powers, or in your ambitions, then Sahaja Yoga cannot do anything. But if you are interested in your compassion and understanding about today's world, how it is in a turmoil. Why? Because of the human beings being in the wrong. What we have to do is to pass them the knowledge of the Divine. That should be your desire, and that is what you will feel very much comfortable with. All other desires, all other wants are, as you say, it's very transitory. One desire is to spread Sahaja Yoga. It's so beautiful that you go on working on it, and every time you do that, you will be so joyous and happy. You will have no problems of any kind. That's the sign of greatness, of Sahaja Yoga. And I want you all to become like that. As today's day is great because we are thinking of all the great saints who came on this earth and who tried to lead us. What they did, all of them tried to spread the truth all over the world. They suffered a lot, they had problems, so many problems. But they worked very hard in every way to spread Sahaja Yoga and drop about God and Divinity. All that is what today you have to give me, a promise that whenever you get any other human being, you can tell them about Sahaja Yoga. Not that is important, but is absolutely immediate need of the world. If you understand this point, that at this time, why are you in this world and what is the need of the world, you will immediately start feeling the responsibility. Whether you are a man or a woman is not important. Go all out to preach, think, make people others understand about such. In every way that is possible. And I think then you will become complete as gurus. If Sahaja Yoga is just with you, you cannot be a guru. Guru also doesn't mean that you go on preaching about Sajava, talking about Sajava, giving lectures about Sajava. No. It means the one who gives realizations to others. How many people you give realization is the thing not to be counted, but to be felt within like ripples, waves of the ocean of love in your heart. So beautiful it is to see that people get realization and are immersed in the joy of spirituality. That's what I want you to do. That's why I am on this earth. I had to suffer also, quite a lot. Doesn't matter, so-called sufferings, I was watching it as like a drama. So, it's okay. Well, as long as you do not pay much attention to all these sufferings, what is so great? Now you have seen yesterday a beautiful drama about Amasa. I always used to think there was such pain about him, that how people have misunderstood and have gone astray. Why they are doing all wrong things? Now I feel happy that at least you people have realized his greatness and have understood and made such a beautiful drama out of it. I don't know how far we can propagate this, but it's a fact that Muhammad Sahib himself was finished. Then also his daughter, granddaughter, children were finished. His son-in-law was finished. And after that, by finishing them, they started another horrible thing called Sunnis. Now the Sunnah religion is not near the truth at all. It's some sort of a very aggressive and a very cruel religion. And that started spreading everywhere. The real Islamic religion of Muhammad Sahib was not there. Those people who killed him started becoming Islam. So this is also a very wrong thing, that a man who was so great and so much of spirituality was not accepted, and somebody who killed him is now accepted. It can happen in anything. But the worst it has happened in this Islamic world, which is very dangerous. And that's, we see that in the name of God, how many bad things they are doing. So try to understand that it is not the fate of Muhammad Sahib it has happened. It's not the fate of reality it has happened. But it's an eye-opener for all of us to see that the truth is always challenged by untruth. And we should stand by the truth, whatever may happen. And a day will come when people will realize that this was the wrong thing they were being, all the time being following, and have been doing all kinds of nonsensical things. All this will work out, I am sure, very soon, if my desire is that powerful, I am sure that they will realize that to be kind, to be nice, to be compassionate is the best way to feel happy, nothing more than that. May God bless you.